Hello and happy, happy Tuesday. So excited to be with you here today. My name is Wendy Lee from CreativeLeeYours.com and I am independent staff and up demonstrator in the United States. So we are going to gather today and do a fast and easy project to kick off our week, right? Yay! Love it. So I got a little sneak peek going behind me. See, I'm behind my head, the start of the next Cultivated Creativity class. So this is a 5-project class that is sent to your door. I love it. It's a new subscription program. Of course, you can cancel anytime, but there is information on my website, creativelyyours.com. Under the Classes and Events tab, you can see it, or you can see it on the homepage of the website as well. It's pinned there. But if you've got questions and want to know more about it, please let me know. But we are featuring an exclusive stamp set each month. Sometimes it'll be a bundle, sometimes it won't, and you'll get a little goodie products, and you're going to have a tutorial and project kits, all kinds of good stuff. So definitely worth giving that a look at if you haven't already. All right, so today, what are we doing? Today, we are going to be working on a fast and easy card that's just easy and beautiful all at once. So let me go ahead and switch the camera over and we will start our crafty fun. All right, there we go. All right, so we are going to be doing this project here. No. My computer is wanting to restart in the middle of the video. Not good, right? Okay, so this is the project we're gonna make today, and I am pulling out one of our gorgeous new designer series papers that's going to be coming out in the new January to April mini catalog. So you can see the catalog here. I cannot open this yet. This does not start until July. Oh my gosh, I'm wishing it were July. It's too cold. This will start January 5th. So as demonstrators, we got to pre-order a few of the products early. So if you would like to get your hands on these gorgeous products early, you can join my Diamonds team and become a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. Enjoy your wonderful discount. Of course, you can choose to, share this with your friends and help pay for your crafting hobby as well, which is always, always nice. But this paper is part of the Fancy Flora Designer product suite, and it's called the Fancy Flora Designer Series Paper. So we've got a little bit here, and then I've pulled in the Friends Are Like Seashells stamp set. This has been in our catalog a couple of years now, and I love it. Love all the sentiments in it. It's just got a really great set of fonts. And I've decided to pair that with a couple of those little brushed butterflies. Whoa. All right. So that is our fast and easy card that we're going to do today. So what we're talking about here is, you end up with these pieces of designer series paper, right? And you're like, okay, what am I going to do with this? It's too small to put on my card front. How do I deal with my layers? All that fun stuff. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this and we are going to split it into two pieces so that we can make our card front out of it. And what I love about this is that you can adjust your layers and use, pretty many different sizes, right? So I want to think this is 3 3/4 by 3 3 3/4 by 3 3/4 is this piece. But if you had something smaller, you could definitely adjust these layers and still accommodate it. So that's, I love it. Love it. So I've chosen another print out of this paper pack. Isn't that fun how it looks like fresh paint? And that's what we're going to grab. And I'm going to show you how I did this fast and easy card today. So I'm taking this designer paper in and I'm pulling in my paper trimmer. And I'm going to slide this into my trimmer. And you know, there's not a right and wrong way to do it. So I'm going to put this point around the 1 inch. And I'm going to put this point around, let's try the 1.5. It might be a little bit more than 1.5, but I think that's the angle I want to have. So I'm going to cut it right across here at this angle. Maybe we'll go a little bit more angled. How about that? And then I'm just going to cut that. So now I've got two pieces with this angle cut. Now you could do it straight if you prefer. I just think the angle gives it kind of a nice extra, right? A little extra touch to it.
So then I've layered it with a neutral piece of cardstock. So I'm just going to lay these down. I'm not going to adhere these yet, just in case, because let's face it, sometimes we drop our stamp or we make a mistake with our stamp. And we actually, because I've done this at an angle and I've done this where it's wider on one end, if I mess it up, I actually have extra tries here. So let's see. We're going to pull in our happy birthday sentiment. Now, do we want to stamp this in Evening Evergreen or Orchid Oasis? I think both would look really, really nice. Let's stamp it in Orchid. Let's just try it. I did the first one in the Evening Evergreen, but we'll try this one in the Orchid Oasis and see how it turns out. And I've got my foam pad underneath since this is a photopolymer stamp set. Just gives it a little extra cushion. So if we don't like how this purple color looks, if it's too much, we'll be able to flip this and do it in the evergreen. I don't know if I love the purple. I do love purple, don't get me wrong. Let's see, do you guys like it better in the purple? Or do you think you would like it better in the evergreen? Let me slide this over and see what we think. So there's the purple. And then if I were to replace this and do it with the evergreen, tough call. I do like them both. I think we're going to go with the evergreen instead of a purple. I think it'll look nicer. I do like how it pulls in that purple color, but let's go ahead and do that. All right. So I told you, and I did not bring a scrub over with me, which is a mistake if I'm switching colors. Let's see if I can wipe it up on a scrap paper. We'll see how this goes. This might be a disaster. All right. So since I have this cut at an angle and I'm wider on one end, look at that. I can rotate this and it's going to cover that up. So I can go ahead and stamp this again, just on the other end. Of course you can flip it over, but this is where I'm saying you're going to get a little extra multiple tries here. All right. So we're going to ink this up with our Evening Evergreen and we'll see how bad this looks. Hopefully it looks fantastic, right? And I'm offset to the right, because I want to leave a little bit of an open space there for my butterflies. You don't have to do that, but I think this paper is so busy. It's got so much going on that that's a nice way to go about it. All right, so we stamped this layer. Let's go ahead and put these pieces down. So I told you this is fast and easy. So you can do this with all your little leftover squares of designer series paper that you just are not sure exactly what to do with. It's just another little way to use those smaller pieces up that you might not know what to do with, right? We hate to throw them away because these papers are gorgeous. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to put my layer in there, my cheater layer. Let me see if I can pull these up. So I wanted this to be framed, like it had another layer underneath, but I wanted it to be easy. So what I did is I took some soft sea foam and I just have some little strips. And I'm going to lay this designer paper right down on that edge. Okay, we'll add a little bit more adhesive since I completely forgot this layer here. So as you can see, you can do it with or without the layer. There we go. There we go. Finally getting it to run. We'll slide this up. You have those days where stamping goes really easy, and then you have those days where stamping does not go very easy. Can you tell which day I'm having? All right. So this would have been good to clip off before I put this down. That's what I did on the original, but I did not do this morning. So we're going to do it without it. It's okay. And I am going to kind of run this a little opposite because I'm going to tuck this in because I already glued this down. We'll see how well I get this. Wanting to stick out just a smidge. And if I can get it even with what I did on the other side, I'm going to. Perfect. All right. Now, because I didn't clip it off before I put the designer paper down, like I said, some days are better stamping days than others, right? We all make mistakes. I'm going to flip this over, but we can salvage this. I think it will still look good, even though I totally missed that. So I do have that green strip showing. Does that bother you guys? Doesn't really bother me. It's a nice subtle layer. Now we could have done the whole layer and left that border in there, but I think it's kind of pretty the way it is. So let's go ahead and finish up our card. I'm going to go ahead and fold my card base. So this is just a standard 4 1/4 by 11 that we're going to fold in half. We're going to pop this up with some dimensionals. There we go. Good, good deal. I hope everyone had a nice holiday, Christmas holiday for those that celebrated. I think Hanukkah was in full swing this last week as well. And then we have New Year's coming up this weekend, and then we're done for a while. So pretty. And then we'll just add a couple of those brush brass butterflies, which I just dropped on the floor. Oh my goodness, I've got butterflies everywhere. All right, like I said, some days are good stamping days and some days are not good stamping days. This has not been my good stamping day, I can see. Perfect. So we're going to bring in our butterflies and let's just sprinkle on a couple. Now they just fell off on the floor. So you would think they'd be super easy to get off of the sheet here. Cute. I'm loving that. Nice. Love all the color. You could pull in all these different colors. Now let's go ahead and decorate the inside as well. I like to bring the design to the inside. So I've got a little strip of designer paper and my very vanilla for the inside as well. So this time I use vanilla. I don't use vanilla very often. I typically go towards white, just kind of my go-to, but I thought vanilla looked really nice with this color combination of this soft succulent with the soft seafoam. All right, so we're going to stamp the "You Are Unique and Completely Amazing." So you could use this for a birthday, wonderful birthday card for a friend or a loved one. All right. Add this little bit, strip of designer paper. We all have these little bitty strips. These are great to just bring that design to the inside, something simple and easy. So yeah, so you could pull in designer paper with just about any sentiment, you know, any stamp set that has a sentiment in it and do the same technique. Cute. Love it. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So much fun. So hopefully you guys will give this a try using up some of your scraps you know, have some fun with it. We don't like to leave all those extras out there. Hey, Jean, so glad you're here. I'm glad you're liking this one. Yeah, fast and easy. So use up those little scraps. You can adjust these layers again, like we mentioned. It's just so, so much fun and pretty. So again, if you want to get your hands on this Fancy Flora product before January 5th, you can go ahead and join my Diamonds team. You can add it to your starter kit, or you could choose to place a demonstrator order right after you sign up and get it that way as well. Your wish list is long. It's a great way to get in there and get some products at a discount. All right, perfect. I hope you guys enjoyed this. And I will see you next Tuesday for a little more crafty fun. And Happy New Year.